Alright guys, so 2nd of October today, it's about 6:30 in the morning and we are going to be doing the first dead bait session of the year. We're on the river today. You know, there's meant to be some big pike in here, so hopefully we'll get some big fish today. Using two rods, float fishing. First baits we're using, we've got red mackerel, red smelt, not red mackerel, and normal mackerel. Basically what we're going to be doing today is just two rods out, fish each peg for about an hour. If there's no fish, move to a different peg, and then yeah, we'll just keep doing that. We've got probably 12 hours of daylight to fish, so hopefully in that time we'll catch something. If not, we won't catch something. But yeah, hope you enjoy the video, and probably see you next time we get a fish. Straight in. Nice one. I'll get net. Alright guys, so just filmed the intro and we're straight into a pike already, so yeah, I didn't get the take on camera, but yeah, we've just unhooked him and he's got another person's trebles in his mouth still, so yeah, ours are in net there, red smelt that one we caught on, and then there's someone else's snap tackle right down in his throat, so
I'm gonna have to try and cut it because
when you're dead baiting, make sure you use strong enough line because you don't want that to happen to a pike, but yeah.
You see these old trebles here?
They're old rotten trebles, them, so they've obviously been in his mouth.
So if you hold that tight,
quite a while, but yeah, we're gonna have to cut this because they're right in his stomach, the other set, and hopefully
wiggle it.
That just snapped.
I know.
Hopefully we can. Hopefully we'll be able to throw other set of trebles, but yeah, that's
right,
not
right down his throat. Can't get them out.
Well, yeah, do you want to hold that? Guys, yeah, first pike. Literally 5 minutes into the session, so yeah, awesome start. Yeah, shame about those other trebles in its mouth, but
we'll have to give him some time to rest after that. Carry on.
Oh yeah.
It's all right though.
I'll get Chesty set up after this, then. Eh? Grab that up quick, won't it?
Yeah. Give him some time to rest if you hold his tail like that.
Red snout. Need to get them up tomorrow, that is.
Yeah. Seen bubbling now.
Yeah.
I was thinking, I've hung up five trebles. How come there's still trebles in his mouth?
Yeah.
Because our trebles
here. I know, yeah. Because I could see one there, and I could see one in corner. Yeah, I could see one. I could see one in corner of his mouth, and then I could see you trying to get one from down his throat. I was like, sure, yeah, there are two trebles up there.
Because we're using 30 pound Nash NXT bullet braid,
yeah,
which is like indestructible. It's like rock hard stuff.
Yeah.
We're using soft rods, 2.5 test curve, so there we go.
Off he goes.
That's where you let him recover, so
yeah.
Nice swing away like that. And you can see the devastation he's caused to poor Mr. Smelt right there.
Yeah, that's
see,
that
two
one,
trebles there, so.
On the red smelt, that first fish. Good start. Fish. Fish, fish, fish.
Look at that, guys. Second fish in 10 minutes.
that's a better fish. Oh, look at that. Whirlpool magic.
Yeah. Here she comes, and she's in the net. Oh, that's a nice fish.
Yeah.
It's about, well, it looks about the same size as the last one.
About 8 pound.
Yeah. No, that's not a bad bunch of them rocks.
No, that's not a bad fish. I'll put them at mat.
Yeah.
There we go, fish number two. About 20 minutes into the session, so.
One fish in. Yeah. As soon as we got that one in, another one straight away.
Good start.
So, just taking some of the edge of the water here. Hold the rope with his tail. Just hold his tail.
Yeah.
Start bubbling, and then you'll feel him tense up, and he'll kick, and he'll be away then.
Yeah.
The fragile fisher pike, but he's got teeth, but. You know, you should always try and be as careful as you can with them. Lovely. Completely different markets, the other one a lot duller. The other ones are a lot more defined.
Yeah.
If you're working back and forth and forcing the water through his gills, there we go. See his fin go in there. Nearly ready to go. Nearly ready to go. Beautiful oily octel pike. There we go. This one has been feeding up, you can tell by that they get like a lumpy appearance on the body. Wait for that kick, there we go. He's away. Beautiful, beautiful.
Good start.
That's a better start, really. Just to show how productive their baiting can be on the right day in the right situation. That's the sort of trebles we were using on that rod. Non-adjustable, fixed just ahead of a mackerel on it.
Semi-barbed as well.
Semi-barbed always, or barbless. And you see how easy those hooks popped out when I just pushed them, even though it was right down in its gill rakers, but never use barbed trebles unless you're asking for trouble.
Alright guys, so we just caught two fish. Didn't even have a chance to get cameras set up properly, so footage might be a bit loose, but hopefully you can see what we've got. We've been here. I mean, we've got down at, it's 7:30. We've got down about 7, so about 30 minutes, including setting up, and we've had 2 pike already. So it just shows how productive dead baiting can be for you. We had one on a red smelt, and then the next one, literally just like that, as soon as the other fish were back, took it, and that were on half a mackerel. So, yeah, we're gonna get set back up. We're gonna try another spot. Yeah, we'll move to another spot now. We've had 2 fish out of this one, so next peg along we'll set up in, and fingers crossed get some more pike. So yeah, good start to the day. Is there?
Yeah.
Alright, we checked on the calendar and couldn't see out. Alright, cheers.
Alright,
mate. Is that Ross somewhere else then?
Yeah.
Alright guys, quick update. Turns out there was a Yorkshire Winter League match on the river. So we had to move. So we've gone onto the canal. We had a drive about for about 2 hours trying to find somewhere else to fish, but couldn't find anywhere decent that were quiet where we can film. So yeah, ended up on canal. Hopefully we'll catch someone here. I mean, we caught 2 on river, which is a decent start, so yeah, fingers crossed, get some more fish. So yeah, it's gonna be like a river and a canal video today, so
I will.
Oh no, it's only a little. Just move that to the side.
tub
then. Oh yeah, it might be. Oh, it's a decent pike that, Alex. No, it's a big chunky one, isn't it? There we go. Third pike of the day. You what? Yeah.
Oh, yes, that's a nice fish.
Very nice. That is nice, yeah.
Tell me from in view.
Yeah, you can do. There we go, guys. Third one of the day.
I'm
give this.
Looking out.
Yeah. First decent fish we've had out of this spot, so that's good. Just give him away real quick.
Drop it back up for drop it in there. Oh, that's all my blood, all that fish, not
yeah.
Fish's blood.
I thought it was.
See, we're at £10 there, double.
You're saying £10?
Yeah.
That is 11.75 with the net, so just under £10 that fish.
Lovely jubbly.
I need to release it, or do you want to?
Take it back. You can release it now.
Just let him catch his breath in net for a minute. I was as well, yeah. Off it goes, look. Nice big, look at that swim off. Alright guys, so that was pike number 3 for the day. That was on a mackerel tail, that. So yeah, not going too bad. Hopefully we can get some more. That was just under £10, that one. First two were about £7 each. So yeah, it's not going too bad today. Trying. Yeah. It's not a bad one anyway.
Lost my forceps, I didn't click.
Oh, he's going away.
Staying deep, isn't
it? It is, yeah. That's a decent one, isn't it? Well, it's not too bad. For about 5 or 6. Oh no, it's about £4. Ooh, that is, yeah, in an hour. I can't believe we've got baits out for an hour and I catch one on this.
Yeah, well, we're fishing up the fucking too far up, so this one we had were fucking close in, right?
Yeah.
Turn CCTV on,
have you?
Don't just swipe it in there,
if you can, yeah. Get net in water ready, yeah. Might be a bit too small for a dead bait.
Yeah, but it's not been in the way. Oh yeah, we've only had it there, haven't we?
Yeah. Didn't want a smelt, but it wanted this little yeah. Little thing. You ready? There we go. Look at that fluorocarbon in his mouth and he's not bit through it.
You know, he's quite heavy.
He is, yeah. Aye. Well, leave camera there, I'll walk up with him. Well guys, that's pike number 4 for the day. We've been in this spot with dead baits for about just under an hour, I'd say. And just thought I'd have a go at little perch rod, have a little bit of a mess about. And got a pike and a little perch lure. So yeah, that's interesting, isn't it? Do you want to bring your forceps down, please?
Yeah.
Nice little chunk of that. He's got a hooked nose as well. Yeah, nice scar on its back as well. Okay, he's definitely ready to go. What? There we go. That was 15-pound fluorocarbon as well, and it was right through its jaws. That, and it's got a few cuts in it, but it's not damaged much to say. So, yeah, does show fluorocarbon's quite durable. Yeah. I mean, a lot of people say don't use fluorocarbon light, but yeah, it's worked then. Alright guys, so just going into the last 30 minutes or so of daylight. Not had any fish since about 3 o'clock, so it's been a bit slow this second half of the day, but you know, we had a good morning, so that's where it goes sometimes. You know, fished 7 while 7 today, so solid 12 hours, and had 4 pike. My brother had a nice perch, about 2 pound, I didn't get that on video, but yeah, he had that on. Had that. But yeah. First time I've been dead baiting in about 3 years, so yeah, nice bit of change of pace. Hope you've enjoyed the video, and if we don't catch another fish, that'll be the end. So yeah, if you enjoyed it, subscribe to the channel and check out my other videos. So cheers. Konnichiwa.